friends, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to discuss about multiplication of vectors. Okay, if you multiply one vector with another vector, what we'll get? We'll get it may be either scalar or it may be either vector. Okay, by multiplying one vector with another, it may be scalar or vector. Okay, there we have two types of multiplication of vectors. Okay, in the first one is dot product or scalar product, and second one is cross product or vector product. Right now we are going to discuss about dot product or scalar product. Okay, let us now entering into the topic dot product or scalar product. Right now we are going to discuss this. Okay, first we need to count the two vectors. If you multiply these two vectors, what do we get? We'll get a scalar. Such type of product we are calling it as dot product or scalar product. Okay, here we are taking two vectors which are making an angle. This is one vector A bar, and one more vector we are considering. This is B bar. What is the angle between them? The angle between these two is theta. If you multiply these two vector, what it is giving you? It is giving you scalar. Okay, right now, according to dot product or scalar product, it defines as dot product of two vectors is the product of magnitudes of two vectors and cos angle between them. Okay, here on basis of this definition, A bar dot B bar is equals to product. What is the product? Magnitudes of two vectors and cos angle between them. This is the definition for dot product or scalar product. Okay. And we can define in another way. Here we got two vectors. Okay, B is a vector which is making an angle with A vector. So B component, according to resolution of vector, B component along the direction of A. So according to dot product or scalar product, magnitude of E, product of magnitude of A and component of B. Okay, according to that, A bar dot B bar is equals to magnitude of A vector component of B vector. So simply you can write it as A itself, A into B cos theta. This is giving you one more definition for dot product. Okay, on basis of this we have different cases. Okay, if the angle is varying, what happens to the dot product? Suppose if two vectors which are along the direction, what is the dot product? If it is making an angle 30 degrees, what is the product? What is the dot product value? 60 degrees, 90 degrees, 180 degrees, like that. Okay, right now, if theta is equals to 0 degrees, what will get the dot product? A bar dot B bar is equals to cos 0 value is 1. So we'll get A B. You can write magnitude of A as A, magnitude of B as B. Why? Because cos 0 value is 0, so 1 itself. So A dot B is equals to A B, which is giving you maximum. Okay, and theta is equals to 30 degrees. If theta is equals to 30 degrees, cos 30 value is root 3 by 2. So we'll get A bar dot B bar is equals to root 3 by 2 AB. Similarly, theta is equals to 60 degrees. a bar dot b bar is equals to cos 60 value is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 ab. Theta is equals to 90 degrees. Cos 90 value is 0. So this is minimum. Okay. Theta is equals to 0 degrees maximum. Theta is equals to 90 degrees minimum. Okay. Similarly, theta is equals to 180 degrees. A bar dot B bar is equals to minus AB. Why? Because cos 180 value is minus 1. So, which is giving you negative in magnitude. Okay. Like this, we can take different values of theta. We will get A dot B product formulas. Okay. Right now. Properties. Coming to properties. First property. Commutative law. Product of two vectors A dot B is equals to B dot A. This is called commutative law. Okay. Second one, distributive. A dot B plus C, or you can take A plus B dot C. We'll get associative law. Okay. A dot B plus A dot C. All these are all vectors. Okay. This is called a distributive. Third one. Before taking dot product, I dot I, unit vectors I dot I and J dot J, K dot K is equals to 1. How it will be? I is a vector, direction vector, okay? I, J and K. Similarly, what will get I, J, K are along the directions of X axis, Y axis, Z axis. Okay. I dot I. Both are in the same direction. What is the angle between them? Angle between them is 0. So, magnitude of unit vector is 1. Unit vector giving you 1. Let us take dot product of these two. I dot I is equals to magnitude of I is 1. Magnitude of I is 1 again. Okay. Angle between them is 0 degrees. Cos 0 value is 1. So we will get 1 itself. So I dot I is equals to 1. J dot J is equals to 1. K dot K is equals to 1. Okay. And we can take one more. What about I dot J or I dot K? Okay. I dot J, I dot K is equals to 0. Why? Because what is the angle between them? Angle between them is 90 degrees. When the angle is 90 degrees, we will get minimum, that is 0. So we will get like this. I dot J, I dot K, or similarly J dot K, like that we will get complete different products. Okay. Similar products is giving you 1. Different products is giving you 0. So right now we are going to do dot product. A is a vector x I cap plus a y j cap plus a z k cap. B vector b x I cap plus b y j cap plus b z k cap. Right now, the dot product between A and B, A bar dot B bar is equals to, okay, according to this condition, I dot I is 1, I dot I is 1, what are the components AX and BX, so what will you get, ax bx, I dot I becomes 1 itself. So plus again ay by j dot j value is 1 again plus k dot k value 1. So we'll get az dz. Okay, and right now magnitude of a, a bar magnitude is root over square of the components ax square plus ay square plus az square. Similarly, b vector root over bx square plus by square plus bz square. So the dot product formula we can write, cos theta is equals to a bar dot b bar divided by magnitude of a, magnitude of b. According to this, ax bx plus ay by plus az bz divided by root over ax square plus ay square plus az square, root over bx square plus by square plus bz square. Okay, and right now this is the formula for finding the cos angle. If theta is equals to 90 degrees, then ax bx plus ay by plus az bz equals to 0 when theta is equals to 90 degrees. Denominator term, magnitude of a, magnitude of b becomes 0. Okay, and right now component of a vector along b direction component of a vector along b direction is, what is the formula we get? According to dot product, cos theta is equals to a bar dot b bar divided by mat of a mat of b. Bring a left side, so what you'll get? Component of a cos theta, a cos theta is equals to a bar dot b bar by magnitude of b. You can write magnitude of b like this, or you can write a bar dot b bar divided by b itself. Okay, this is one. Next, component of b vector along a direction. Okay, right now similarly we can write b cos theta. B cos theta is equals to a bar dot b bar by magnitude of a, or you can write a bar dot b bar divided by a itself. Okay, right now here a cos theta, b cos theta, these two are giving you scalar terms. Okay, if you want vector terms, then what we need to do right now? Vector component of A along B direction is A cos theta. In what direction we need to take? B direction. So, in the direction of B cap. So what you'll get, a cos theta. A cos theta is equals to this. You can consider a bar dot b bar by b. But b cap, according to the definition of unit vector, b cap is equals to b bar by magnitude of b. You can write b itself. Okay. So what you'll get along the direction of b direction and square you can write. Okay. This is the formula for component of vector component of A along the direction of B. Okay. Similarly, we can write vector component B along A direction. Okay, directly I am writing b cos theta a cap is equals to a bar dot b bar divided by a square into a vector. Why? Because a cap is equals to a bar by magnitude of a vector. Okay, here we have different cases in this dot product.